Hey guys, welcome back to TechnonTech TV. So in the last video, that is part 1 of SQL built-in function, we have already discussed single row functions and its practical implementation. Now in part 2, we will discuss group functions. So if you haven't watched part 1, then please go and watch that video first to get better understanding of this video. Link is given in the description box. So let's start. Group functions basically group the rows of data based on the values written by the query. The group functions are used to calculate aggregate values like total or average, which return just one total or one average value after processing a group of rows. So there are three types of group functions: group by functions, having function, order by function. So let's discuss it one by one in detail. First is group by function. The group by clause is used along with the group functions to retrieve data grouped according to one or more columns. This clause was added to SQL because aggregate functions like sum, count, etc. return the aggregate of all column values, and without the group by function, it was impossible to find the sum of each individual group of column values. So consider department table. And suppose you want to know the total amount of salary spent on each department. Then if we write query like this, then this is invalid because the column return is not part of aggregate. We are getting wrong output. So group by function can solve this problem. Now we are using group by in our earlier query. So here we can see we get total amount of salary for every individual department. Here note one important thing: group by clause should contain all the columns in the select list, except those used along with the group function. So if you are using department and department ID column in select statement, then you have to use both column in group by clause. Group by clause can only be used with the aggregate functions like sum, average, count, max, and min. If it is used with the single row functions, Oracle throws an exception. Next is having function. The having clause is used for aggregate functions in the same way that a where clause is used for column names and expressions. Essentially, the having and where clause do the same thing. That is, filter rows from inclusion in a result table based on a condition. While it may appear that a having clause filters out groups, it does not. Rather, a having clause filters rows. So suppose we need information of department with salary greater than
45,000.
So the resultant output will look like this. So here if we don't use group by function, then we'll get this error because having clause is conditional option that is directly related to the group by clause option. Because a having clause eliminates rows from a result table based on the result of a group by clause. The order by clause is used in a select statement to sort results either in ascending or descending order. So Oracle sorts query results in ascending order by default. So suppose here we are using the same query that we have used earlier for group by function. Now we are adding order by clause on column salary. So here we get salary data in ascending order. Now if we want data in descending order, then we'll use DESC in order by clause. So the resultant output will look like this. So that's it for this video. If you understand this video, please share your valuable feedback. And if you want more update about my new videos, so please subscribe to my channel.